umuntu yaba ari hanze aho yica abanyarwanda cyangwa se afatanya n'abica abanyarwanda mwafatanya na FDLR n'abandi ntibimugireho ingaruka ahari twumva ari responsibility y'ibyo bihugu kubakurikirana batabakurikirana u Rwanda rukabikurikiranira sibyo twabiganiriye kandi tuzakomeza kubiganira hari na bamwe muzi hari uwiyita Sankara Major uwiyitwa Major Sankara Kalisita Habimana nawe umaze iminsi avuga ko yafashe Nyungwe yigamba bya bitero byishe abantu za Kitabi n'ahandi akajya ku maradiyo akabivuga akajya ku maradiyo akavuga ko azakora n'ibindi ko ibyo ngibyo bidahagije hari n'ibindi ashaka kuzakora akajya ku maradiyo akigamba urupfu rw'abanyarwanda abanyarwanda bapfa imodoka batwitse icyo gihe ibyo rero twabasobanuriye ko icya mbere ntabwo bazabishobora ntibashobora kubishobora kandi ko twebwe nk'u Rwanda nka Leta y'u Rwanda itazabyihanganira akaba ariyo mpamvu dukoranye n'abandi mu nzego zitandukanye Major Sankara yagaruwe mu Rwanda hano akaba inzego zibishinzwe ziri bumushyikiriza ubucamanza kugira ngo asobanure ibyo bintu akora ntabwo ariwe gusa n'abandi rero bakiri hanze bagamije kwica abanyarwanda guhungabanya umutekano w'u Rwanda nabo amaherezo bazabibazwa n'u Rwanda ndetse turasaba n'abandi abo dukorana ibihugu by'inshuti nshimira ibyinshi rwose urabona dukorana neza dufatanya kugira ngo aba bantu bagamije guhungabanya umutekano w'u Rwanda ibyo bikorwa byabo bihagarare muri rusange nibyo twaganiriye hari ibindi twabagejejeho yaba muri politiki yaba mu bukungu ariko cyane cyane muri iki gitondo nibyo twaganiriye n'abadiplomate with those few remarks why don't I open it up for any comment questions etc why don't you manage this Oh, there are a few who don't understand. I thought people in the region also understand Kinyarwanda. Yes. I explained Kinyarwanda that this morning we had a briefing with the diplomatic corps, which is one of our regular briefing sessions with the corps. This morning's briefing session was aimed at exchanging views on recent development in our country. Specifically, I updated them on the security situation in Rwanda. Rwanda continues to be safer today than it has ever been in its history. I shared with them that there have been, as they know, there have been attempts in the past by some Rwandese leaders of armed groups, criminal armed groups, many of them operating from Eastern DRC with support of some of our neighboring countries to cause insecurity in Rwanda. Some of the leaders are based outside of Rwanda, some are based in Europe, a man called Rusesabagina, who has claimed responsibility for some of these attacks, is based in Belgium, has Belgian nationality, travels to the US. Some of them, a man lives in France, Nirichina, Major Nirichina, ex-genocidaire, ex-ex-farm, participated in the genocide here, has been claiming his attacks. Kayumba Nyamwasa, who you know, lives in South Africa, and his other people, the Himbaras, Mkanghusi. These are people who live in Canada, in Belgium, that some live in the Netherlands. There's one who is even a legal representative of RNC in Germany and so on. So there are these people who live outside of Rwanda, are causing insecurity in Rwanda, and yet claim protection of the countries where they have sought its nationality when they are being asked to account for their criminal activities in Rwanda. And this is an issue we've put before our partners, different countries. We think it's not acceptable. This state of affairs is not acceptable. A number of the countries, of course, have worked with us to either prosecute them or extradite them. But those that have not been yet prosecuted or extradited, we are asking that this be done. The most recent egregious example is of a man called Calix Habimana, who calls himself Major Sankara, you know, who in the last month has been claiming his group, the FLN, his group, has been claiming responsibility for the attacks in Nyungwe, Kitabi, Nyamagabe, Nyaruguru, that killed a number, some Rwandese. To one point, they even burnt a vehicle. So he's been claiming, publicly claiming responsibility for this. And also claiming that he's planning many other activities, many other terrorist attacks. We did not take this lightly, and so the government, working with through its own diplomatic and other means, managed to have Sankara. He's back, he's here in Rwanda, and he will face the courts, the justice system, to answer for his crimes. It's not only him, these others who are also doing so, claiming responsibility for killing Rwandese, or publicly planning to destabilize our country, will eventually face the law. And Sankara is the latest. But as you know, a few months back, some of the FDLR leaders were also planning to cause insecurity. Were brought to Rwanda. They are now being held accountable for their crimes. Those who are still out there will also eventually account for the crimes against the Rwandan people. I took the opportunity to thank the diplomatic corps for those countries that cooperate with us, continue to cooperate with us, and urging that this cooperation continues. We thank many countries that have worked with us in making sure that these people are brought to account. We will continue to work with them to do so.